On March 11th of 2011, disaster struck Japan as a massive 9.0 scale earthquake hit. But what would soon follow would be something that no one would expect. 1446 JST, compressional stress that had been accumulating between the Pacific and Eurasian plates from long before finally gave way. Due to high pressure and friction reducing 5 meter thick clay layer between the plates, the Pacific plate subducted under the Eurasian plate by about 10 to 30 meters, releasing massive amounts of energy, rumbling the Tohoku region and causing buildings and structures to collapse and take serious damage. The earthquake was felt across Japan, with the heaviest damage being sustained on the eastern coast. Unbeknownst to the residents of Japan, this would soon trigger an event that would make the earthquake pale in comparison. Within 30 minutes, a massive tsunami, triggered by the earthquake, swept across the land, toppling in at 30 meters high, overtaking the protective seawalls and ripping through houses and buildings. Over the course of the next few days, 123,000 houses were completely destroyed, 20,000 people were dead or missing, and 3 nuclear reactors were disabled, resulting in the Fukushima nuclear power plant disaster. An additional 1 million houses sustained damage, adding up to $199 billion in financial damage, or $235 billion in international total economic cost, making this the costliest natural disaster in world history.
The environmental impact caused 6,600 metric tons of industrial gases into the atmosphere, equivalent to roughly 19.2 million metric tons of CO2, harming the ozone and creating pollution that harmed residents in the neighboring lands. Of the animals that died, 110,000 Laysan albatross chicks were swept away. Thousands of Bonin petrels were buried, and thousands of fish were washed up on the shore to suffocate. Many species of plants and animals were forced by the current into different habitats, which could cause unforeseen damages in the future. Through distribution of the natural ecosystem, satellite imagery shows that much of the land is still submerged underwater, but the plant life has been completely destroyed in some areas. And new seawater has replaced the previous water in lakes and rivers. Since the cost of life and damages were so catastrophic, Japan is putting more priority into bringing in tsunami experts and other earth scientists research Japan's earthquake and tsunami history to predict and prevent damage from future natural disasters. From the damages and lessons learned from the 2011 Tohoku earthquake and tsunami, the Japanese and neighboring governments will take more precautionary measures so that they are better prepared for similar events in the future.